Oh, hi. Oh, yeah, I gotta turn the air conditioning off. It's too loud. What's up, everybody? We're live in the Hopper Food Kitchen. It's Wednesday. Oh, my God. I haven't been on the channel in, like, 6 weeks. Sorry, not sorry. I was traveling, doing my thing. So tonight we're doing a live recipe because that's just what I thought would be fun to do my first week back. And so let me check in on the chat room over here. Let's bring it over here. Everybody's here. What's going on? Tammy, Helen, Millie, Unicorn Vomit, Hope, Caroline, Hallie. Cool. Hi, everyone. Okay, so recipe is where I don't know what I'm doing. So we better get going. I keep this to an hour. I don't know what I'm doing. I will let you know I performed a recipe earlier today, which is an edited version that will air next week. So I actually, I'm not going to lie, I was looking at this sad bowl of things here, and I was like, we should use this stuff. I actually have a lot of avocados that I need to use up. I think I have like a lot. Like this one, and I was like, what the heck are we gonna do with all this? We can't just make guacamole. That would be boring, and we'd be done in 10 minutes. And then, you know, I was sort of thinking you can make sweet stuff with avocados. Like you can make like a creamy, like a, you know, like people make chocolate pudding, which I've never actually made. That could be interesting. Hello. Just keeping my eye on the chat. Everyone's saying it's hard to hear me. I don't know. We're trying our best here. I don't get it. The phone, unless the phone is crapping out, we're doing this on my iPhone. Should be fine. When I watch it, it's fine. Turn up your volume. Wear earphones. I don't know. So the plan is to use, I have 1, 2, 3, pretty much 4 avocados. And since they are like kind of going bad, let's take a look. You never know what you're gonna get. I do actually think you could make a chocolate pudding, but maybe I can like add on to that because chocolate pudding is like, it's basic, but like if it's good, it's good. We could make like a layered thing. We can make other like layers or fillings or things to go on the pudding. Because I'm not just gonna make pudding. Lame. We've never made a sweet thing on a live either. Everyone's like, savory, savory, but like, sweet, man. I already had like food today, so I kind of want dessert. All right, look at these. These are great. Avocado mousse, avocado fries. So I actually already have an avocado fry recipe on my blog. They're deep fried. I have got the deep fried avocados stuffed with Jafford in the cookbook. You know, we could make a boring salad with this or something. I actually think I've never made avocado mousse, and I'm even skeptical that you don't taste avocado. I don't even think I've ever eaten avocado mousse, which is crazy because I'm vegan. So let's try that because, and we'll go from there. So, I'm assuming you use a blender, not a food processor. What do you think? Blender, food processor? I'm sure either's fine. Maybe food processor because maybe it doesn't get in there well enough. And you don't really want to add liquid, just sugar, like maple syrup. What y'all saying? Chili chocolate mousse, both work. Okay, well then let's just use the blender because I like the blender. So, what's going on? Has anyone watched my, I posted my What I Ate in LA vlog today. Also, you've seen all my travels. Food processor. Oh, shit. Guys, I don't know. I don't want to change halfway through. Make avocado ice. What's that? Mary's Test Kitchen. What's going on? She said mug cake. Yeah, mug cake. I mean, I have actually chilled coconut cream, so we could definitely make a whip. This should be a no-bake thing. But like, what could you put, like, a cookie? Like, I want something crunchy. So if you got whipped cream, and then you got mousse, it's all soft. Cake is even too soft. I want something crunchy. Like, do we make, like, a quick, like, granola crunchy thing? Or, like, a crunchy can? Oh, like toffee? Oh, like, what do you call it? Brittle, like a peanut brittle, like a crunchy, shard of peanut brittle, like with the chocolate mousse and then whipped cream and like, ooh, you know what I'm gonna put in this? Coffee liqueur. I have coffee liqueur over there. Okay, that's what we're doing. Do we have to cook the liqueur out? I don't think so. Toasted nuts, avocado brownie, granola avocado bowls, peanut brittle's amazing, said Emery. Yeah, let's make peanut brittle. I think it doesn't even take that long to cool, so we should probably make that first. Oh, is this making too much pudding? We have to use all of this up. Keep it boozy. Okay, I'm definitely adding coffee liqueur to this. The quality of the video is bad, says Lavina. I mean, this is a live stream. Live stream kind of is bad. It only runs at 720p, doesn't it, Alex?
Most likely.
Yeah, 720p, not 1080p. So this is as good as it gets for live. I think Lavina hasn't seen the live stream before because we've been doing this every month now for a few months. Seems to be fine. For the real hardcore Hot for Foodies. Of course I do the edited version of this, but the live one's fun because it means I don't have to plan a video for this week. Quality's good, quality's fine. So that must just be people's servers. Okay, let's just do that anyway. I thought I saw some peel in there. Guys, I have no clue what I'm adding into this. Should we do the peanut brittle first? Yes, because it needs time to like cool. Okay, we'll come back to this. Peanut brittle is sugar. Let's go to the stove. We're gonna do it in this. I used this earlier today and I just cleaned it, which is why it's sitting here. Do you think we need the light on? Okay. Sugar, we're going into my baking cupboard here. Baking cupboard has what now? Oh, I don't really have any sugar. Shit. What do I have? Coconut sugar. Really hard brown sugar. Powdered sugar. Uh-oh. We can melt this brown sugar into peanut brittle. We'll just combine white and brown. We have vegan butter that's in the fridge. I didn't even go in the fridge just to get avocado. That was funny. Oh, I got the coconut cream all here ready to go. Okay. You know, we don't need to make too much brittle. We can just make it on this. Do I line that or do I just butter that? Line it or butter it? I think I just butter it. Alex is filming, as he always does. Okay, well, first of all, we need this on the heat. We need butter in the pan.
We're getting a lot of suggestions for line it.
Line it, yeah, okay. That's what I was gonna do. Butter. That's a cup there. Should be good. Parchment paper. Very loud, sorry. Eh, keep the edges on. Now, what's great about peanut brittle, this doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to be sweet and peanut-y. Really just butter, sugar, salt, peanuts, right? Butter, sugar, salt, peanuts. I've never made this stuff. I'm so excited. Okay, here we go. That's ready to go. Butter is melting. We'll add in our really hard sugars. Or do we let this melt first? I don't know. Here we go. Do I have peanuts up? I think I do. I think they're in here. Peanuts. Yeah. Salted and roasted. Perfect. This butter is also salted already, so we might not really need to add more salt. This will melt faster if it's smaller. I'm kind of excited about this because I really love making desserts. I know they don't do as well, like they're not as popular as the savory, but I like making desserts and giving them to people. Okay, so that's happening. Gonna need more sugar than that. Oh my god, I hate when this brown sugar does this. It sucks. It's all the same in the pan though. Shit. Sorry, I'm not talking. I'm really focused. Okay, sugar in the pan. We'll stir the peanuts in after, I think. Anything interesting?
Oh, there's some comments here and there suggesting one thing or another, but nothing of note that I can suggest as of yet.
Okay. Guys, we can't turn up the volume. This is running through an iPhone. It is what it is. We're working on troubleshooting that for future live streams, but this is really how people live stream, unless they have like a huge setup, which is impossible to do in here, especially when you're bouncing around the kitchen. So, I mean, I don't have to do these. That's the thing. I can stop doing them if they suck, but... I thought they were okay. Whenever I wash them back, they're fine. Make sure you're using a heat-resistant spatula. I think I have to add water to this.
Apparently, if you add baking soda at the end, it'll make it a little bit lighter and not so hard.
Oh, like more like a praline type thing, probably?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think I want it kind of hard. No, I mean, like a, because everything's going to be so mushy, so I feel like this should be crunchy. I don't know. Dumb, don't do this at home. I'm gonna go the heat a little bit higher. This is so dumb what I'm doing. Okay, cool. So let's just get this going. Bubble up, guys. And then it shouldn't take long to harden up. So then we can just leave that and then make the pudding. Now, once the sugar starts bubbling, you don't want to be touching this because it gets very hot. Does it need more sugar? Possibly. I'm going to do whatever falls off here. It's weird. Anyone know how to soften brown sugar? There's like tricks for that, but I forget. It's actually good. You can just cook it down if you're doing, if yours is hardened like that.
Jin says when brown sugar is hard, microwave it for a few secs and it will be soft again.
Okay. I'm making a mess. Thanks, Jin. Okay, it's starting to bubble. Great. I might switch to a whisk. I actually think what would be great is if it spread out so much that it was like fairly thin and then the peanuts were like sticking out of it. I'm really focused, sorry, I'm just concentrating here. Can't really keep up. A brown sugar bear. Oh, yeah. Those are those things that keep it from going. Yes, it's a cat dishcloth. Corn syrup. I don't have corn syrup. I think this will be okay. I'm guessing that so you don't burn, which is a common trick, just keep stirring. You want this though. It's getting thicker, caramelizing, crystallizing, or whatever you call it. Watch your heat. I'm on like a medium heat doing this. Oh yeah, so if you're just tuning in, I'm right now making a peanut brittle, which is gonna go with a chocolate avocado mousse and hopefully some coconut whipped cream. We're gonna make a dessert today. The vegan butter sticks are earth balanced. Jackie saw me in Picton, yeah. I think we only need to really do this for about 10 minutes. Bubbling, cooking it down. The key is here, you want to get the sugar to the point of like where it will harden, because like midway, this is just a caramel sauce. And then if you keep getting it, if you cook it longer, I think it changes the crystal formations in the sugar so that it actually hardens. And I think you can hear me better when I'm behind the camera, like right now. Oh, who is that? Isabel going to Toronto this week, so she wants to know where to eat. Isabella. There's a new place called Rosalind. It's vegan Mexican. I saw Lauren on Bumble. Yep, that's me. Holla. It's not a fake account. That's so funny that whoever just said that, was it Jordan or something? Because that's all I've been talking about today. Bumble. And yesterday and the other day.
Yeah, it was Jordan.
Did you swipe me? JK, JK. All right. So you kind of want to look at like the thickness, like how it's running off the spatula. I think we can go a bit longer. I'm just guessing here. I've never done this. Because what we don't want to happen is for it not to harden, like, and it just sort of stays like a goo. Saltier the better. I guess the peanuts are salty. Should I just add a, I'm just gonna add a pinch of salt. Won't hurt. All right, so survey says going in the chocolate mousse, cocoa powder, maple syrup. Is that it? Do I have to cut it with like any coconut milk or anything? I don't really know. Anyone has a suggestion? Oh yeah, everyone on the chat's giving you restaurant recommendations for sure. Did someone say melted chocolate? Yeah, melted chocolate, okay. Put a drop in a glass of ice water to see how hard it is. Oh, you're so smart. Is that what I should do?
Yeah, I think we've had a couple comments recommending that.
Recommending that? All right. I'm just going to have to grab a glass over here. I don't think I have ice water. Can I just run the tap? I think that's going to be too loud. I think once it's looking thicker right now, like the really thick bubbles, that's what we want. Let me get some water. Well, that's not even cold at all. I don't know, that's pretty gooey. Look at it sticking to that. That's even, look, it's just hitting the air. That might be it. Look, if it's not dripping, I think that might be it. Yeah. It's hard. Now, how do I get it out of there? Okay, I think we're good. It's been about 10 minutes, hasn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's add some peanuts. Also, it's hard over here, so. Oh, God, this is going to be good. Okay. Do not touch this with your fingers. Ooh, lots of peanuts, not lots of peanuts. Maybe I need a bigger sheet. It's gonna be too thick. I messed that one up. Oh, the peanuts, yeah, nice. Let's save some for the topping of the thing I'm making, the mousse or whatever. Okay, that looks good. I definitely need a bigger sheet pan. Stand by. What is everyone saying? Oh, yeah.
20 seconds.
Yeah, but we're not cooking anything. We're 20 minutes in. We're making avocado mousse in just a second. I just made peanut brittle.
And we're also having recommendations of buttering that as well.
Buttering this also, you think? Okay. Whatever y'all are saying. Quickly, let's do that. I'm using my hands. Don't be gross like me at home. Or be gross like me. What else? Sorry. Move to the side. I think it needs lots more. What do you guys think?
We're still having recommendations for baking soda. The amount of explanation points are getting long.
Why do you want me to put baking soda in it? Don't we want it to be hard? Why would I put baking soda?
Don't need baking soda.
Yeah, I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. I don't want to taste baking soda. You know what I mean? Oh, yes. Holy mother. This is exciting. Oh, I can bring the leftovers to my family picnic on Saturday. Oh, that's a heavy pan, sorry. Okay, get it out to the edges. I mean, it doesn't really matter if it... I don't know, I think I had too much butter on there. I like how many peanuts I put in it. I'll say that. Now, should I put it in the fridge just for... the sake of speediness. Anyone? Everyone? I think maybe yes.
First person, yes.
Okay.
Took a while for it to come in.
I think there's a bit of a delay.
Fridge, freezer, yes, 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 please.
Okay, but it should get us to the end of the segment, I'm thinking. Okay, maybe this is hot. I'm gonna put this over here to cool off. Actually, I better not. Ooh, that's so hot. It's gonna start heating up the fridge though. Just making room. I'm gonna put it on the shelf. What's everyone saying? Fridge's goals. Put it at the top of the fridge. Oh, I can't clean it up. If you want it to be hard like caramel, shouldn't you bake it? No, you just let it air dry. I know that. Okay, y'all. Here we go. Avocado chocolate mousse. Cocoa powder's up there. I need that stool. It's a child. I don't know if you can hear this child running upstairs. You probably can. It's very loud. All right, we have chocolate chips. We have cocoa powder. I have more somewhere else, I think. Vanilla extract. Actually, I'm going to use vanilla powder. And then we have maple syrup. Okay. It's going to need a lot of cocoa powder. Do I add any milk, guys? Oh my god, this is riveting. That's what Ashley said. That's funny. Okay, so if you're just joining in, welcome. This is live recipe. We make up a recipe. I'm adding vanilla powder. I've got lots of avocados, cocoa powder, milk, okay. Maple syrup. I only have almond milk, but that's fine. I don't want to taste any avocados in this. I don't want that, you know that bitter taste? Yeah, y'all are saying melted chocolate. What if you did a thick chocolate mousse to go with the light mousse and the crunchy brittle? No milk, mix first. Okay, let's just try. And then we'll add a splash of milk, see where we're at. I think I have too much avocados in here, not gonna lie. Where are we at? What are we doing? We're making chocolate mousse with avocados. I just made peanut brittle. It's in the fridge because I wanted a crunchy thing to go with my mousse. And then I'm gonna make a coconut whip, which you know how to make. Because I tell you how in my cookbook. Liqueur, I was gonna add. Okay, this is gonna be loud. Stand by. Do I need the thing?
I was just seeing Snickles. Oh. We scared him away.
Of course we did. We're going to need to do some mashing. Maybe a food processor would have been better. Gonna stir it up in there. This is riveting content, isn't it? Just watching this. Okay. I think it's gonna work. It's just gonna take some muscle here to get get it going. It smells amazing, actually. So I put a lot of chocolate and a lot of sugar in the form of maple syrup. Okay. Gonna do this and make it in a food processor. Oh, it's gonna be amazing. I just gotta get it smooth. Should I switch appliances? Is anyone saying that?
No, there's a lot of comments though that your arms are gonna be jacked by the end of the video.
Yes. I mean, even if it's a bit thinner, like I don't really care, right? Like we're still gonna make it like a layered thing with the brittle anyway. And the cream. Okay, where are we at for time? Jeez.
32 minutes in.
Uh-oh.
Getting a bit of suggestions for maybe some more milk.
It's really good. It needs a little bit more maple. So the maple's gonna help move it. One sec. Okay, everyone's like, stick with it, right? I saw someone.
Yep.
Okay, a couple people. Definitely a bit more sugar. Definitely a bit more of this. Not gonna kill you, that stuff. It's gonna make it taste really good. Okay. Ooh, boozy chocolate avocado mousse. Man, I need like a water paper towel. Okay. This is it. This is the one. Getting warm too, which we're gonna have to chill it because we don't want to eat warm pudding. Oh my goodness. too. What a mess.
Something like that.
So close. I just had a lot of avocados. That was the problem. What?
Oh, just some of these comments are just
making
really
rude
funny.
Poo comments?
Hot for poo.
You know, I like a good poo joke. Okay, it tastes flipping amazing. It's not too sweet, which is perfect. You know, I think it's fine. It's smooth enough. I'm gonna put it in a bowl. Let's look at it. Mmm. A lot of it. That's the crazy thing. All right. I have truly made a mess now. There's a lot of pudding in here. Oh, yeah! Okay, you know, I was skeptical of the avocado. I thought, there's no way. I mean, well, everyone makes this, but I'm always just thinking I'm gonna taste avocado. This is delightful. You know, you could do this for my tiramisu if you don't want to use tofu, because that mousse I made with tofu, but look, you could just use this. Always one-upping myself. Okay. Someone said Taco Bell aftermath. Gross. Okay, so let's make some whip. Do I need another appliance to do that? Oh god. There's still quite a bit in here that I can't quite muster out. So that's fine. We're just gonna leave this. Okay, I'm gonna put this in the fridge also. Brittle is brittle. That's a recycling bin. Okay, how many calories? I don't know. Don't ask questions like that. I literally have no idea. What else are you guys saying? Thick. I love that. THICC. Whip again. Whip again? Whip again? Boozy peanut brittle avocado mousse, said Venetia. Precisely. I mean, do we need... look, we gotta do this. How much time? We have 20 minutes. Okay. This will not take long at all. Coconut cream. These are canned. This is a can of full-fat coconut cream. I think I just need one. I don't know. Marissa started making the same thing along with me. Oh my god, I have chocolate everywhere. Am I getting it all over myself? You have to make this whip with a hand mixer or a sand mixer. Sorry to say. Can't do it by hand. So let's get my sand mixer. Holy jeez. I'm gonna put it right here, Alex. One sec. Okay. Oh yes, I did get a new sand mixer. Cord. Oh wait, it's battery powered. See, I haven't even used it yet. Is it battery powered? Oh my god, do you love how I have no idea? Oh, there's a cord right there. I haven't used it yet, I just got it. Okay, welcome to Idiot Cooking. Lauren Toyota. I need a three prong thing, where's that thing? I'll get it. I was like, where did we put that? Okay, this is a lot of work.
This is why we edit most of the videos. For food.
It's clean. I cleaned it. That looks like a good whipping one. This might be a dusty, actually. Just wipe it out quick. This is a game changer, this mixer. This is also a huge bowl that I probably don't need. I need this huge bowl. Don't get any of the liquid, but this is mostly all cream in this can, so I should be fine. Has to be cold and solid. This has been in the fridge for months. Because I was going to make something with it. So, I'm just going to get it all. Oh, yeah, it's so hard. It's like bending my spoon. This one has a little bit of liquid on the bottom, so just avoid that. Get it all in there. Okay. And you can add a bit of powdered sugar to sweeten it. Oh, there's still more in there. If we need more, we'll just do a second can. Okay, never used this before. Should smooth out, I hope. Not too fast. Okay, seems amazing. Whippy. Looks so thick. It's thick. Oh, wait, you're talking about pudding. Haven't made dough in this yet. Mousse is like whipped chocolate whip. What are we talking about?
People were wondering what the difference between mousse and pudding is. So they're discussing.
Don't ask me. I'm not the expert. Let's just go a little longer, I think. I don't know. I know you're not supposed to add liquid to it, but I almost feel like if I did, it might be better. That was vanilla. Locks and then I got it on here, so it has to come off. Oh Lord, okay. Who's saying add nail clippings? Is that a troll? Okay. Pudding, it's not too warm. Was talking about. Holy crap. It's a bit more like a praline right now in terms of the way the sugar's crystallized. It's not, you know, I didn't even do a baking soda, and I think it did exactly what you all were saying. It's actually nice. That's not like hard. Okay. What are we doing here? Putting on the bottom. Okay, this is crazy, yo. So much crap, okay. Putting on the bottom. Oh. Are these the right jars?
You could use wine glasses. We did get some suggestions of just wine glasses.
Wine glasses are cute. So it's just like mousse, whip, piece of brittle. Guys. Yeah, I think mason jar is like the obvious choice. Let's go with these. Now be very delicate so you don't get it on the edges so that it can look like a nice... Oh, like, don't do that. That's so hard, okay. Not that hard, it's not a big deal. It's gonna take so long to style it. Mess. I'm trying to get it like smoothed out to the sides. Yeah. Imagine me trying to make that tripe before the cookbook. And that's why the photo's so messy, because I was like, there's no way it's gonna look good. Okay, I'm not gonna be that picky, but I'm gonna have to make a nice looking one for the photo. Plus I'm making like fingerprints all over this thing. Okay, what do you guys think? What did we call those burritos that I made? Did we use the word thick?
Yeah.
So this is also thick. I don't remember what we said or called it.
I can't remember either, but I know thick was definitely involved.
I want to make this look nicer. My OCD's kicking in.
Stephanie Armour is the thick Rito.
Thick Rito?
Is that what we called it?
Idea, kind of going up the glass like that. That looks kind of cool. I'm being weird. I don't know if that looks good or not. See, I just like smoothed it around. That looks stupid. I don't know. Okay. Now, this isn't really good whip. It's a little, maybe I whipped it too much because it's a little like butter. Ooh, I wish I could pipe it in. I have all that crap. What is that? Okay, I can do it really fast.
You have 9 minutes.
Oh, God. That's my challenge. I could pipe it in, it's gonna look so cute! Reusable piping bag, let's go.
No.
Everyone think this is stupid?
No. But there's been hilarity all...
Okay,
all.
You're entertaining yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know what's happening. This is pointless. Okay.
Alex Welch. Alex wielding the big stick of time tyrant.
Holy shit, okay. avocado mousse, coconut whip, and homemade peanut brittle in about 50 minutes. Ready, y'all? We need to get a bit of brittle in there. This is good. It's missing one other thing.
What's that other thing?
Fruit, maybe?
I don't know.
We love a delicious disaster. That's what your man calls me, mama.
Okay, you guys are naughty in the comments.
This isn't quite, I guess I overdid the sugar because I didn't really want it to be crystallized. I want it to be smooth and hard. But it's still good. Okay. I'm going to keep reading your comments for fun. I don't have any fruit. I have no raspberries or anything. Make a berry compote. We gotta go, man. What am I going to do with all this stuff? It's so much peanut brittle. Thank you so much for watching. This is always really fun, even if I feel like I'm a crazy person during it. Next week, it's an edited recipe, and I made empanadas. They're really good. And then my waffles two ways is coming up the week after that. All right, that's it, man. Thanks for watching. Thank you, Alex. Thank you, everyone. Peace out. Love you. Bye.